أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. إن شاء الله we continue from رياض الصالحين في باب فضل البكاء من خشية الله تعالى وشوقا إليه. The chapter of the virtue of weeping out of awe of Allah or reverence of Allah سبحانه وتعالى and looking to meet him. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سبعة يظلهم الله في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله: إمام عادل، وشاب نشأ في عبادة الله تعالى، ورجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد، ورجلان تحابا في الله اجتمع عليه وتفرقا عليه، ورجل دعته امرأة ذات منصب وجمال فقال إني أخاف الله، ورجل تصدق بصدقة فأخفاها حتى لا تعلم شماله ما تنفق يمينه، ورجل ذكر الله خاليا ففاضت عينا. متفق عليه. أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said seven categories of people will be shaded under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. First one is a just ruler. The second one is a young man or woman who was raised in obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, a man whose heart is attached to the masajid. Number four, two people who love each other for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they meet only for Allah and they depart only for Allah. And number five, a man that a beautiful and wealthy woman called him for fahisha, but he said, I fear Allah. And number six, a man who is given a sadaqah and he is making it secret and hiding it to the extent that his left hand does not know what his right hand has given. And the last category is a man who remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he was alone, so his eyes became tearful. So these are the seven categories that will be saved on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. They will be under the shade of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, starting from just ruler and coming down to the last one, which we will talk about, which is a man or a woman who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while they are alone. Nobody is around them. Because when this happens in the presence of other people, it might not have the 100% sincerity. They weep and cry out of fear of the punishment of Allah and khashyatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the respect, reverence, and awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we want to become from this category, to be shaded under the shade of Allah on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, to be saved, then if that happens to us, this is a sign that our heart is a good and sound heart. When we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by ourselves, nobody is around us, and then we think about him, we think about Jannah, about Nar, and then we weep, we cry, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept what we did from good, and he subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive what we have done from bad. And al-buka min khashyatillah is one of the fastest and closest ways that we can come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we said in Salat al-Fajr, those whose hearts are soft and sound and they weep and cry out of respect and reverence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those are the ones whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed. those are the ones who have living hearts, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us before, that the example of the one who remembers Allah and the one who does not remember Allah is like the example of the living and the dead. مثل الذي يذكر الله والذي لا يذكره كمثل الحي والميت. The Muslim who remembers Allah a lot, he has a living heart. Living doesn't mean the blood is pumping in the heart, because all of us having this. Living means a heart that's always remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A heart that's always conscious of the deeds that we do. A heart that always helps our tongue to say good and helps our hands to do good, because it all starts from the heart. As also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, there is a piece of flesh in our body. If it becomes good, all our body will be good and everything else will be good. And if it becomes bad or corrupted, everything else will be bad and corrupted, and this is the heart. So, al-buka, weeping out of respect and reverence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was from the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and it was also the way of the Sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim, and it is the way of the righteous. If we become among those, when they hear the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they weep and they cry and they remember Him a lot, and their hearts are trembling, then we will be from the saved sect on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our hearts safe and sound from any innovations and from anything against the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our hearts bump always with His remembrance and always with the salah upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to help the Muslims around the world to be good and to help each other. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the well-being in dunya and the well-being in the akhirah. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. اللهم عافنا في أسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا أبدا ما أبقيتنا، واجعله الوارث منا، واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا، وانصرنا على من عادانا. اللهم ارزقنا قلبا خاشعا، اللهم ارزقنا قلبا خاشعا، ولسانا ذاكرا، ولسانا ذاكرا، وبدلا على البلاء صابرا، وبدلا على البلاء صابرا. اللهم ارزقنا الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وجزاكم الله خيرا.